for 10 days, but this video really isn't about that. It's time to go pick up our new camper. So what we've done is I've packed a little bit of stuff, a little bit of kit, bedding and stuff, to get us started for a couple of days. Give it a little bit of a run. Australian made, Australian owned business. They have a pretty good reputation, really good resale value too. They got a Facebook page, and they've got their own owners forum as well, which is like a website based members group. Well, that was a quick look at the matrix that we're picking up. As I say, 2 weeks tomorrow. They do a little bit of electrical work on the Land Cruiser as well, just to make sure it's gonna marry up with the matrix. And as we've ordered a reversing camera for the matrix, I gotta install that in this as well. Very busy at the moment. Our gross trailer mass is going to be, I think it's 2,700 kilos. We've got a GTM upgrade, and the back maximum they'll do is 100 kilos extra on top of the standard, which I think is 2,600 kilos. Dry weight, I think, is about 1,850 kilos, depending on what options you stick in it, what accessories you hang off it. Tow ball weight, well, that varies, I suppose. Again, how you pack it, whether it's dry or wet or anything like that. A back end of the matrix, generator box, spare tire, jerry can holders. You can see a lot of this stuff on the AOR website. They ask that when you pick up, that your top of the tongue for where your tow hitch is be about 500 mils above ground level, but not above 500 mils. And you'll notice the blue, it's the same as on the Ultimate, and same as on the Land Cruiser. It's an 8H6. Fast progress photos I saw, didn't have the windows in. They have DO35 hitches as well, which is why, if you've been watching my videos, when we were at Geraldton, I think it was, we had the Treg hitch replaced with a DO35, apart from the Treg hitch shooting itself. So the inside, queen size bed, bit of storage underneath. Amp hours of lithium. Boss will be pretty happy with the progress. The air conditioning in there. Pole carrier.
Black
It took about 3 weeks of negotiation. No promises to match up with the Land Cruiser. I'll give you a paint code, that's it. I had two questions. Does it come with a step for getting in and out?
Yes, it does, and you get a plastic step.
Rightio. Yeah. It doesn't come with a bottle jack, does it?
I'm unsure about that. I'll have to find that out.
Rightio. Back in here, day before handover. We've just got it in the showroom at the moment. Checking it out. The mattress in, as you can see. Still haven't got the seats in, but I suppose we're going to do that. Need to have that open for tomorrow when we're doing the handover. Shove us through there with blast arrow and water filters. Didn't show you the cockpit last time. It's got the red vision system. Boss is checking out pot drawers. How deep is that one, Prue? You just locked it. That's right, isn't it? See if I can get the cooktop out and show you.
Deeper than
the
one inside.
Mm. It's another 2-burner outside. I mentioned last time a grill. Some more storage. That must be for the burner. That's like a windshield. Extra shelf. Weber Q in here. Got some little cutouts here. I suppose we could put some bungee straps or something over it to hold the Weber Q in place in transit. Oh, storage. Lots of stuff there. I can see the Auspit going in there, easy enough. ISI bike rack. I've already got some mods lined up for this. I'll talk about them in a separate video. It's the brake master cylinder. Robusto diesel oil filler. That's got to do with the black water tank. It's like a vent. It's a storage all the way around, bro. Switch there for the macerator pump, or to pump it out, the black water. Bit of canvas in there. That shelf is for the air conditioning. That other shelf underneath it is for the side. A brake safe thing, so if the brakes away from the truck, it'll anchor the brakes. A light out the back here as well, and we've got a sail truck out here for a shade sail as well. Diesel heater cover. Water tanks front and rear. Rear one's been split. They're both 140 litres. Front one's just water. This one's been split 80 water, 60 grey water. This is meant to fit the little 2 kVA generator that we bought. The Perth 4x4 and outdoor adventure show. Showed you this last time. I pulled it out this time. It wasn't fitted properly, so it's just been crushed up. Hopefully they'll pick that up. Otherwise we'll have a chat tomorrow. This is the brackets for our shelf for outside. TV aerial. 12 volt power point. One of these is press in the center, pull up, 240 out, 240 out. The way this differs from most caravans is you can't hook it up to water mains and run off our water mains. It still runs off the tank. So when you pull up at a caravan park, for example, and you want to fill up, or you want to get a site or something like that, even if it's got water, it's not going to do much good to you unless you fill up the tanks. That's a firewood storage tray. Apparently these weigh about 15 kilos. Gonna mod this as well.
Just a boy, Christmas brought so much joy. Couldn't wait for the presents and laughter. I couldn't sleep late at night, looking for Santa with lights. Those are the memories I still remember. Then I became a man, lost sight of who I am.